So I'm in an old barracks turned into a museum or bunkhouse. Well, it's really cool to see these old guns on display. Unfortunately, the ones that are real have all been disabled, which is just disheartening. Here we have a communications room. Here's the radios that have been used by not just Canada, but the US. And even in this case, this is a German field telephone. And you would have to crank this 100 times just to get 1 minute of calling out of it. So somebody would be really going at her. Here we have a German machine gun. These are the Enfields, so the Canadian rifles. Although this one apparently was a dummy training rifle. This is an old gas mask from 1904, I think he said. So definitely not, it's not something I would want to trust myself with. Or I wouldn't want to trust that to keep me from not choking to death on gas. These are actually for making quick, temporary barbed wire fences. You screw them into the ground and then run the barbed wire through the loops. And then these are vases that are made out of shells. And this is something that somebody in the trenches during the war took a shell, an artillery shell, and actually made these vases. So that's something you don't really think about in the trenches. They'll make an artwork out of it, spent shells. So here, this room is more devoted to the Navy, who actually practiced launching planes here when they were first introduced to aircraft carriers. It's kind of making me want to play with it. Oh, hey. It's kind of making me want to play with them, just like... Here we have some uniforms. These are dress uniforms. These are battle dress. This is a Kevlar vest from the 80s, and it is heavy as hell. Alright, so this is an old flight jacket. And so every 1,000 feet above the Earth you go, the temperature actually drops by about 3 degrees. So at 10,000 feet, it's 30 degrees colder than it is on the ground. So, and during a hot summer's day, when it's 30 degrees, it means zero while you're in the air. Or if it's a winter's day, and it's already like negative 10, then it's negative 40 up there. Somebody, I guess, who lived on the base, and they're just kind of turning all the rooms into different exhibits. Got some furs over here, and a hat. I wear hats. So this thing right here, this is actually a hand-powered vacuum cleaner. So you would yank on this, and that would pulse, it would create suction, which would suck dirt into here. So this is actually like a hand-powered vacuum cleaner. That's so cool. This obviously used to be a bathroom, so I don't know if this would have been an officer's, like somebody of importance, if this would have been their bunk room, because it gets an attached bathroom. because the rest of them, I'm sure, do not have attached bathrooms. Friggin' beautiful old shotguns. Wish I could take that and throw it up on my wall. Drill, and it literally, you would plug this into the wall and then use your foot to power it. This is the alert system. So that's DEFCON 5 being everything's cool, DEFCON 1 being horrible, ADE being we're all dead apparently. This was if there's gas in the area. This one's obviously security. Or no, wait, this is, I think he said this was the planes. So the pilots are on standby. Pilots are about to take off. Pilots are taking off. Available. Here's the Highlanders. Nova Scotians will know who these people are. Kilt-wearing soldiers. Chapel room, or this exhibit is obviously in the chapel room. I must admit, I have never seen a paperback Bible. Never, ever. You didn't actually show me this room. I don't know what this is, but there's an old surround sound system. That's basically a laptop right there. Here's for the peacekeepers. These are three peacekeepers from Nova Scotia who passed away. God rest their souls. So this is a map thingamadinger, but you would take a small picture of a map, stick it in here, and it could project your map onto the ceiling. So that instead of everyone huddling around the table, you could all just look up at the ceiling. Like a dust or a dart. Kilt, part of the military uniform. You don't see that nowadays. Here's actually something really special. This is the only exhibit like this in the entirety of Nova Scotia. These are all pictures taken by the Russians of the Russian military experience. So that's why you can tell it's in Russian at the top. Oh, it's Putin. But yeah, they had a particular miserable experience. 20 million of them died.